the Lord, everyone. Hallelujah. Would you stand with me this morning? Let's just welcome the presence of the Lord in this place today. Amen. It's good to be in the house of the Lord on an Easter Sunday to lift up his name. Let's just thank him for all of his goodness. Lord, we love you. We worship your holy name today, God. We give glory and honor to your mighty name, Jesus. Lord, there's none like you, God. Hallelujah. We bless your holy name. Bless your holy name. Praise God. So good to see all the colors, all the smiling faces today. Good to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. We've been listening. They've had youth conventions all over, and I was listening to one of the songs, "There's Something Happens When I Call Your Name." Man, I got to listen to it. My nephew's playing the drums in there, and that boy can tear them up. And I'm like, man, something happens when we call the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Can we call on that name today and lift up the name of Jesus? We give you praise, God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. There's something about being in his presence. We want to welcome each and every one of you here this morning. You may be seated. We're going to have a video for Save Our Children. Okay, I don't know if we have a video or not. We'll get ready. If the kids want to come up and get ready for that while she's working on that, we just want to welcome everyone into the house of the Lord today. So good to be a part of that. Today we are going to be taking up an offering for Sheaves for Christ, or for Save Our Children. It's right here, if I can get it right. Just read it, Frank. But anyway, we are going to be having an offering for that. And we want to give you a chance to give here in a little bit. Amen. Get all the children here. Praise God. All right. Let's just worship with them. Man, I tell you what, they practice, and you could feel the Spirit of the Lord moving in this place this morning already. All right. God bless you.
Are you past the point of weary? Is your burden weighing heavy? Is it all too much to carry? Let me tell you about my Jesus. Do you feel that empty feeling? 'Cause shame's done all it's stealing, and you're desperate for some healing. Let me tell you about my Jesus. He makes a way where there ain't no way. Rises up from an empty grave. Ain't no sinner that he can save. Let me tell you about my Jesus. His love is strong.
Jesus, his love is strong and his grace is free.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Has he changed your life today? So glad I know who Jesus is. Praise God. Amen. A lot of participation there. Praise God. Hallelujah. So good to see everyone again. I know I keep saying that, but we got here early today. I'm not used to being here before the sun comes up, so it's been a long day already. But to come together to see the sun come up and then worship the Lord, and we're so thankful for his presence today. Don't forget about our Save Our Children that's we'll be giving here in just a little bit. And we want to remind you about our prayer meetings. We have prayer meetings here on Tuesdays for the ladies at 10 a.m., men prayer on Saturdays at 9 a.m. But next week we'll be going to Mountain View for a men's breakfast. Yes. So if you're going to be a part of that, let Brother Brad know. We got to give him a number for men's breakfast next Saturday. Amen. And then we got a revival coming up. How many love revival?
Amen.
Amen. Next Sunday morning and Sunday night, Brother Lane Muse is going to be here Sunday. Two services, 10 a.m., 6 p.m. Come for revival service and see what God is doing in West Plains. Amen. Let him change your life. Praise God. Hallelujah. We want to ask the choir to come at this time, and we're going to give each and every one a chance to give. Let's just pray over our offering as we get ready to give. And don't forget, this will be for our sheaves. Save our children. Save our children.
God knew.
Got a video now. Let's play that video while your choir's coming.
Before he formed me in my mother's womb. Shh. He knew my name.
My ministry.
My gifts. Before I can preach.
He knew I would change the world.
My personality.
Before I can plant churches.
I can plant seeds. Some people think we're too young, but we have to start somewhere.
We're not the church of the future, we're the church of now.
Because what happens next starts now.
Start now. Help us reach our goal of $4 million for SOC.
Visit upcichildrensministries.org to find out how you can get involved.
All right, let's pray over this offering as we get ready to give this morning. Lord, we love you, Jesus. We're so thankful for your many blessings. Lord, we pray for our children today, God. Lord, that your spirit would overshadow them, Jesus. Lord, that we would give our heart to you in a mighty way. Lord, I pray you bless our offering, God. Help it go to this use, Lord Jesus. Bless each one who has to give. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Hallelujah. We welcome you to come around the front and give this morning as the choir gets ready to sing.
Praise the Lord. Happy Resurrection Sunday. Aren't you excited to serve a risen God today? Hallelujah. There's coming a day when every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that he is Lord and King. And the whole earth will sing his praises. Sing with us today. Hallelujah.
Glory, worthy of honor, worthy of praise.
We will shout and proclaim the greatness of your holy name.
You're worthy of glory, worthy of honor, worthy of praise. You are holy. You are whole. worthy of glory, worthy of honor, worthy of praise.
You. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Yeah.
isn't he worthy? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, Lord. We praise you, God. Hallelujah.
Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. We're so thankful for the presence of the Lord today. We want to take our needs to him this morning and lift up our needs. I know there's several that we requested prayer for. They'll be on the list up here. Would you just join with me and let's pray for our needs this morning, that God would touch everyone that's on this list, that he would touch your heart today, that we could lift him up in praise. Lord, we love you, Jesus. We're so thankful for your presence, God. We're so thankful, Jesus, for these men today, these ladies who need prayer, God, on our list. We know that you're able, God. I pray, Jesus, for Brother Gustavo, Lord, for Brother Cecil, for Sister Mary, for Ken today, God, forever. But Lord Jesus, for Miles, Lord, hallelujah, for Brother Johnson, Lord, we pray for each need, each hand that was raised today, God, if we pray that you would welcome your spirit into this place, that you would touch each heart and life, we ask you, Jesus, to minister to us today, Lord, that you would touch lives, Jesus, hallelujah,
you're worthy of it all,
Lord, just so worthy. All that's within you, sing, you're worthy.
You're worthy of it all.
Oh, so worthy, Jesus.
You're worthy of it all. For from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve.
Let's give him glory this morning. We praise you, Jesus. We give you thanks this morning, Lord. How great and marvelous you are, God. Hallelujah. We praise your mighty name, Jesus. We praise
you. Would you guys sing that one more time? Just sing it again. And as they sing it, I want you to look toward heaven and just give God praise from your own heart here today. Thank you, Jesus. Wonderful is your name. Holy is your name. Righteous is your name. One more time. You're worthy. You're worthy, Lord.
You're worthy of it all.
Praise you, mighty God. I lift you up. All praises to your name. You are Jehovah Jireh. You are Jehovah Nisi, my healer. You are my deliverer. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. While you're standing, I just want to add to Brother Frank's sentiments, how glad I am to see you here in the house of the Lord. Thank you, worship team and choir. Could we give the choir a great big hand? Thank you, choir. Hallelujah. Amen. And if you would just stand in honor to the word together today on this Easter Sunday, I want to read Romans 15. And 13, and I know you guys have been up and down and standing, and you have been here since early this morning. And so I am conscious of that. So I will have you stand every 3 minutes or so to make sure you're awake, all right? No, Romans 15:13 says, "Now may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit." Oh, I want to just rejoice in the one who can make us abound today. The one who can give us to overflowing today. Hallelujah. Could you just thank him one more time for being that God? Joy unspeakable and full of glory. Thank you. Hey, try to find about two or three people near you and give them high fives and say happy Easter. Amen. And then you may be seated. God bless you. What a wonderful group we have here today. I rejoice with you. I see families. I see grandmas and grandpas and great-grandmas and great-grandpas. And I see babies down to the infants. And I see elders. I won't say old people. I see lots of people here today. Amen. So glad for all of you that have come to celebrate this most beautiful occasion, and that is the Resurrection Day, the Life Day. We have life, and he gives it abundantly, doesn't he? And God is our hope, and the joy that we have comes from that hope this morning, and I'm glad I have hope in Jesus as my Savior. You see, I believe that without him, I'm lost. And I must be saved. And I believe that he is the one who saves me. He is my Savior. And I will be complete only when I am complete in him. And so thankful that he is my Savior. I'm declaring today that what God can do in your life today is to give you great hope. And when you have hope, you can have joy to the overflow. Amen. Hope is a feeling when you begin to have faith in God, and that feeling you have isn't permanent, that feeling that you had before you had hope. And so when I declare, how many would declare with me today, this is Resurrection Sunday? Would you do that? Everyone say, he's alive. In me. Amen. That's what we're going to declare here today, is that he's alive in us. He's the Savior of our life, and he gives us overflow. The world is a dark place that is filled with negativity. It's filled with all kinds of things that will cause you to be down. And you know, we all have to go through the dark times of our life. And I wanted to share a story to start out with here today about a man named General Robin Reisner. This man spent 7 years as a prisoner of war in Hanoi. He was a prisoner in their compound in North Vietnam. They called it the Hanoi Hilton, and obviously it was not a fancy place to stay. There he discovered the power of hope, because as he was there for 7 years, 4.5 of those years spent in isolation and 10 months of it in total darkness. That has been known to drive people crazy. And in those 10 months, sounds like someone's car. It's a white Jeep right there is going off. If you accidentally bumped your keys, you might want to try to fix that. And it's not the sounding of the trumpet yet, so just don't be alarmed. But this man, he spent this time in 10 months, and it would obviously be considered to be the 10 longest months of his life. And how many of you are people? You like to be around people. You just kind of, you know, it makes you happy to be around people. And I would say this, how many of you just kind of you know, you know that you are self-sufficient and you can kind of be okay with having your alone time. But how many of you would like to stay in a dark room for 10 months? I don't see any takers here today. That would be a bad place to be, and that's where he was for 10 months in a very dark place. At one point during those 10 months, he found underneath a section of bench or something, he found a crack, and he was able to look down through that crack and see a little pinpoint of light. And down at the bottom of that pinpoint of light, he was able to see a single blade of grass. And he said, "You do not know what that meant to me, just to be able to look down through that darkness and see a single blade of grass." Now, I don't know about you, but I've tried to fast from time to time, and when you're on a fast, isn't it amazing how good a saltine cracker sounds? Just, I mean, it just is like a feast. It sounds so delicious. But when the mind is losing hope, we can get a hold of something. Even the Bible says, even as small as a grain of mustard seed, just a little bit of faith, a little bit of hope. I'm here today to hopefully get our minds into a place where we can begin to see that we must have hope. The human spirit is strong. It is capable of doing great things. But when you lose hope, you lose all. We're creatures of hope. How many's been hoping for some warm weather? Anybody besides me? Come on now. Anybody been hoping for a little bit of warm weather like we had yesterday? Woo! And today, man, I was so thankful I got out there this morning. We walked outside, and it was still 60 degrees, and I knew we weren't going to be shivering in our boots at the sunrise service. That just made me so happy, Brother Dakota. Man, the Lord is good, and he gave us a great sunrise service, 53 people there, and I just was wonderfully blessed to be a part of it, and felt excited. Been looking forward to this time of the year. We're going to plant some things. We're going to get to grow some tomatoes. Come on, Sister Pat. Say amen. And so we're here today to talk about the hope. The answer that we have today in the greatest hope that we can have is in Jesus Christ. Isaiah 40, verse 26 says, "Lift up your eyes on high, and behold who had created things that bringeth out their host by number. He calleth them by names, by the greatest of his might, for he is strong in power and not one that fails." I'm glad I have hope in the one who's strong today. He will not let you down. I said he will not let you down. Oh, I'm glad to have hope in him. Let me just shed abroad a little bit of hope here. I asked Sister Sharon to testify. I think we got to just share it with the whole group here today, Sister Sharon. And I want to just testify. We've been having a lot of sickness around. We've been having a lot of folks go through cancer people go through things that it just seemed kind of feel hopeless. So today I want to give you a little bit of hope and share your testimony that you shared here this morning.
So my husband has been suffering since March the 4th with a lot of pain. He had a catheter and he was in severe pain. We saw the urologist. The urologist said, and he used the dreaded word cancer, he said, "It really looks like, you know, looking us straight in the eye, I really think it's cancer. I really think it's cancer." And he said, "But don't worry, it's a good surgery. It can happen. It can be taken care of." So I guess if you have cancer, that's one of the better ones to have. But who wants cancer? Nobody wants cancer. So I'm waiting in the room for the doctor to come out after the surgery and procedure, and he comes in and he sits down and he says, "Good news, it's not cancer." And he took care of the issue and got the they were bladder stones. One doctor says bladder stones, the other doctor is like, "It's not bladder stones, it's cancer." So we're shouting victory today. We're
a good report. I don't know about you, but I need some good reports. Oh, so there's a good report back there. Sister Linda, I didn't know you were going to make it. You said you were sick and not going to be here today. Oh, I'm glad you made it today. Oh, hallelujah. I'm looking around here at all these blessings. Amen. Brother Sanders, you got a great big bunch of blessings around you here today. Wonderful. I'm looking around here and seeing all of these folks here today that you appreciate what God's done in your life. And you're here, you're saying, let's get together. Oh, what God's doing in our young people. Ooh, I'm excited for you. Hallelujah. Skylar, I loved what you said when you came up to me this morning and you were giving me what the Lord had, stand up here so everybody can see you. You were giving what the Lord had spoken into your spirit while you were at the convention. And I heard the testimony of how you are ready to make a further commitment to God. And you feel like the Lord has taken you into a direction that is going to require a little bit more of you, and you're ready to give it. And I am excited about that. I love that. I love that. I know each one of you have testimonies. You're going to get to share them. We're going to do that next Sunday. Amen. But we're here today to talk about the good things that God's doing. The blessings that he's bringing to our lives. There's things that we're dealing with that if we don't have the Lord, we don't have much. I said, if we don't have the peace of God in our lives, we don't have much. If we don't have the joy of the Holy Ghost, we sure don't have much. But I'm here today to say, it's for you. It's for you. Point to somebody, because I can't point to you all. Tell them, say, it's for you. It's for all of us here today. We can have hope in what God's going to do. And he has good plans. You know, sometimes we feel like that the plans are not working out the way we want to, but God has good plans for you. We don't understand everything that's going on every moment of time, but let me just say this. If you're in the hand of the Master, of the Good Shepherd, of the one who has good plans for you, then everything's going to be all right. I believe that. How many believe that today? Everything is going to be all right when you put your hope in the Lord. There's situations that we deal with in our lives that they drain us of hope. Those medical situations, they just begin to drain us of hope. But when we look to the Master and we hold on, and the Bible says, he that endureth to the end is the one that's going to be saved. And so we just endure some troubles and trials for the moment to be able to step sometimes into glory and in his marvelous light and say, it was all right. Anybody testify to that today? You can look back and you say, I was there, but now I'm here. I once was blind, but now I see. I'm here today to be a living testimony to say, it's all right. It's going to be fine. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, all your mind, all your strength, and love him like you've never loved him before, and you're going to be okay because there is joy that comes in the morning. Hallelujah. We talked about that in our sunrise here service this morning. You know, Paul wrote to the Colossians, and I want to read from Colossians chapter 1. He says there, we have heard of your faith in Jesus Christ, and of the love you have for all the saints, the faith, the love that springs from hope that is stored up for you in heaven. Oh, somebody say, pour out the hope in my life. Amen. We often talk about the joy being poured out. There's hope stored up for you in heaven. Somebody just needs to get a little bit of hope here today. Amen. Because when you get hope, it nurtures something in your spirit that turns into joy. Amen. I wish I could do a backflip off of here. That's the way I feel right now. Amen. Somebody say, don't do it, Pastor. I just feel a little bit of excitement here today about what the Lord is able to do. Hallelujah. Oh. Amen. I used to be able to do a backflip.
That's I did on a trampoline. Amen. How many believe you have an eternal hope here today? An eternal hope in glory. That's one of the things that keeps me going, is my eternal hope. Amen. I'm privileged to be acquainted with a great man, and I have a picture of him here today. And he wrote a song. It's titled, I Want to Go There. Say something that's in my office, and it's a piece of sheet music here. If I were to open it up and be able to play on the piano, it has all the notes and the chords there. But the words of this song, they say, I want to go there. Anybody know what he's talking about? He kind of strengthens it up a little bit. He says, I mean to go there. Anybody mean to go there today? Amen. He says, Christ said I could go. His word told me so. The beauties of heaven to share. I want to go there. I mean to go there. A mansion awaits just inside the gates. Oh, I mean to go there. I'm telling you here today, church, you've got to have a hope in glory. You've got to have a determination that you're going to make heaven your home. You've got to decide in your heart and in your life that my eternal home is in heaven. And I've decided to go there. Amen. I mean to go there. One of these days, I want to go to Hawaii. I've been talking about that. Told my wife I was going to take her there for our 30th anniversary, and something came up, and we didn't get to. But, baby, I mean to take you there. I'm going to do it. We're going to go there someday. And we've got that in our plans. I'm just telling somebody here today, you need to make up your mind, I'm going to go to heaven. I'm going to go to heaven, and I'm going to do everything that I can to make sure that I get there. Amen? How many's decided that here today? The Lord is, I just feel like this. You've got to be living your life in such a way that it says, I'm planning on going there. Yeah? You've got to have that kind of, life that you're living that says, hey, this is where I'm going. Amen. I'm headed toward heaven. 1 Corinthians 10, verse 13 says, no temptation has overtaken you except it is common to man. And God is faithful. He will not let you be tempted beyond what you can bear. When you're tempted, he'll provide a way out so that you can endure it. But you got to have, it says, endurance there. You got to be saying, I'm going there. Yeah, something messed me up a few years ago, but I'm going to make up my mind. I'm going to go to heaven. Amen. He provides a way despite our doubts, despite our mistakes. I'm telling you here today, church, let me just say, now's not a time for giving up. Now's a time for making up your mind. Amen. I don't know all about this eclipse stuff I've been seeing, seeing all these prophecies and all these things that's lining up and everything's aligning in such a way and it's going over Salem 17 times and all of these different things. I don't know about all that stuff, but I do know this, the Lord is coming back someday. And when he comes, I intend on being ready for when he comes. I've got hope. I've got hope. I've got hope. Amen. And so I'm glad to know here today, don't focus on problems. Focus on the one who's able to help you endure your problems. Have hope. Tell somebody that's by you, say, don't give up. I said, don't give up. Amen. One of the things I like is the illustration about the oak tree.
an oak tree that you look at. There's a big one right out there. And you can go ahead and look out the window for a minute if you want to. There's a big old oak tree out there that one day it started as a little bitty acorn. And every acorn that is able to begin to grow was just yesterday's nut that held its ground. Now, I didn't call anybody a nut here today, but I'm just saying sometimes we feel like a nut and sometimes we don't, right? But the scripture says here that we can have hope and wait for the patiently for the salvation of the Lord. Lamentations. Jesus said, and the gates of hell will not be victorious over you, against you. And so can the worldly problems stop us? Somebody say no. Amen. They vanish once we put our hope in the Heavenly Father. He has risen and He is victorious. And when we feel hope, I feel like our outlook changes. Amen. I feel like it. It's like that little boy. He was laying sick in the hospital bed, and he had been burned very severely, and he had lost hope. And one day his teacher got together some homework and brought it up to him, and she said, I'm here to see you. Johnny, you need to get to working on your homework. You've been missing too much school, and you need to, we got verbs and adverbs, and anybody like all that stuff? We got all that stuff to stay on top of, and you need to get to working on this. Amen. And so she did the work, and the next day the nurse came to her and they said to her, what did you do to Johnny? And she said, oh no, I just was trying to help him with some homework and try to help him stay up a little bit. I'm sorry, what happened? They said, oh, it's not bad what happened, it's good. It's what has happened is Johnny is up working on his homework, and he's now got a good perspective on life, and he's feeling like he's going to live. In fact, Johnny said, if I've got homework to do, then it must be I'm going to get better. Let me just tell you here today, if the enemy's fighting you hard, just know this. There's a heaven, and he's trying to keep you from it. I believe that. Sometimes whenever the enemy fights real, real hard, and I'm just about ready to be pushed down underneath the load, I just get energized, and I begin to say, oh, I see what you're doing, devil. You're trying to get me down. It lets me know the Lord's doing a good work in me. It lets me know that God's getting ready to do something special. I'm going to stand up here, and I'm going to just shout it out to the mountaintops. I've got good news. Everything's going to be all right. I said, everything's going to be all right. I said, everything's going to be just fine. You believe that? Oh, I believe it with all my heart that everything, because I've got hope. That old song, I've got hope when trouble comes my way. I've got hope since Jesus has come to stay. Hallelujah. Well, I need that hope to be able to fuel the things that God's going to do in my life and how He's going to bring joy into my life, because I have hope. Amen. I was born in the flesh in 1964. Some of you young people say, man, that's old. You didn't have to really say it. I was born of the Spirit in 1976. Amen. The Bible says that which is born of the flesh is going to die, but that which is born of the Spirit is going to live forever. Let me just give you hope here today. You're in a soul-saving station. You're in a place where you can be born of the water. There's water to be baptized in. You can be born of the Spirit. In fact, John, the Gospel of John, if you read it, it's a great book. Amen. How many read your Bible? I want you to read your Bible. Raise your hand if you're going to start reading your Bible more. Amen. I want to read. I want to know. Read John. It's a great book. In fact, it's one of the great ones that I recommend. If you read John and Acts, it's a great place to start reading the Bible. But in John, it says there's a man who comes, and
he's wondering about what all is going on. In fact, he's a Pharisee. His name's Nicodemus, and he's wondering about this being saved business. And Jesus speaks to him, and he says, you must be born again. And he says, how can I be born again? I've already been born. I'm an old man. And he says, you got to be born of the water and the Spirit. Let me ask this question here today. How many believe it's important to be born of the water and the Spirit? Amen. When you're born of the water, the Spirit, there is a new man that begins to take refuge in your life. To be born of the water and the Spirit. There's a new man. The Bible calls it a new creature. And it begins to work in you and change your life. Amen. It says in Luke chapter 18 that it's impossible. I'm the wrong place in my notes here. Romans 8:24, it says, for in this hope we're saved, but hope that is seen is no hope at all. Who hopes for what he already has? But if we hope for what we do not have yet, we wait for it patiently. Amen. And it's talking about that hope of salvation. Let me just say here, if you're feeling unwanted today, God wants you. Do you believe that? It's there in Timothy. It says it is his will for all to be saved who come to him. If you're feeling unloved today, God loves you. Somebody get with me here today. It's excellent in thy loving kindness, O God. Where therefore the children of men must put their trust under the shadow of thy wing. Amen. I love optimistic people, don't you? Well, the rest of you must like negative people, so I'll pray for you. But I myself, I love positive, optimistic people. I like this little boy, little leaguer, and I like the way he looks at his situation and can learn a few things. He says, there's a man that comes to him. His little league game is going on one afternoon, and the little boy is sitting there on the bench, and the guy asks him, he says, what's the score? And the little boy says, they got 18, we got 0. And the man said, oh, man, you guys must be feeling pretty low then. He goes, oh, no, we haven't got up the bat yet. That's optimism right there, my friend. Amen. It may be 18-0 right now in your life, but just get up the bat. Come on. Just have some hope today. Just have some hope today. I want the musicians to come, and I don't want to hold you too long today. I know it's been a long day, but I want to just say a few more things. I want to give you hope, all right? It's kind of coming in here, they say. And you can begin to just, with me, think about this time that we're going to have a prayer at the end of this service. And then we're going to get outside. Look, the sunshine's coming out there. Amen. We're going to have an Easter egg hunt. It's going to be a good time. Amen. While the musicians are coming, let me just read from Ephesians chapter 2 for you. It says, but don't take any of this for granted. It was only yesterday that you were outsiders to God's ways and had no idea of any of this. And you didn't know the first thing about the way God works. This is a paraphrase, all right? I think it says it clearly, and I want to just say it for you in this way. It says, you didn't have the faintest idea of Christ. You knew nothing about what rich history that God's covenants and promises were to Israel. And you didn't have a clue about what God was doing in the world at large. But now, everybody say, but now. Because of Christ dying that death and shedding that blood, you who were once out of it, it was 18-0, and it was your last at bat. You were out of it altogether. Now you're in on everything, not because of what you do, not because of your abilities, not because of your stature, not because of your status, not because of where you were born, not because of how you were raised, not because of your color of your skin, not because of any of that, but because of Jesus Christ dying on a cross and making a way for hope in your life. Let's stand together all over this room today. And if you'd like to gather with us around this altar, you feel welcome. If you don't feel comfortable with that, you can stay where you're at. But we're not going to do anything but just stand up here together and pray here today. Amen. We're going to pray. And I want to just leave you with this. Back in the olden days when they were first figuring out submarines, there was a submarine that was built that they were testing it. It was back in the early 1900s. And they were testing that S-4. They were right off of Massachusetts and doing their trials. And unknown, a Coast Guard destroyer accidentally rammed the U.S. S-4 submarine. And those that were in it went down. They could hear them on the, they kept, somehow some of them got into a place of where there was air, and they could hear them kind of tapping on the hull. And in fact, they knew Morse code, and they tapped on the hull these words: "Is there any hope?" And unfortunately, there wasn't, because there was no technology at that time. But because of that accident, they made technology that would allow for people to be saved if that ever happened again. And so it was in later, about 20 years later, there was another ship. Put the screen up that of the other ship, the Squalus submarine, and it went down because there was a device created. Show that device. There was a device created called the McCann Rescue Chamber, and with that technology, they'd be able to put it over that hull and create a place that they could come up through safely and they could be saved. And here today, you may be feeling like you're in the bottom with no way up, but I have a Savior. And He's made a way. He's provided a way for you to have life, and not only have life, Brother Dakota, but have it to the abundance, right, to have it to the overflow. And so we rejoice in that here today. And we steadfastly stand upon that promise here today. And so as they sing and we just kind of connect here with what the Lord is doing and just reach out and say, Lord, I want to live with my hope always on You. I want us to pray, and I want us to get a vision of heaven. And I want us to see ourselves there. I want us to get a vision of a life that is joyful. And I want us to believe that that's where we're going here today. And as we pray, begin to visualize and just trust in that hope. Would you pray with me here? And just in this moment of prayer, just kind of begin to let some of those things that I said begin to work in your life. Lord, in Your name, I pray for every person under the sound of my voice right now. God, that hope would just resonate in their spirit. A new hope that they've never had before. Maybe they touched this hope at some point, but it comes alive to them here today. I pray, Lord, that they would see themselves walking on the streets of gold. That they would see themselves, Lord, free of the sorrows of life and the troubles of life right now. And that Your hope would begin to work in them. That Easter hope, that resurrection hope. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
We worship the God who was. We worship the God who is. We worship the God who evermore will be. He opened the prison doors. He parted the raging sea. My God, He holds. We won't be quiet. We'll shout.
Amen. I just feel led to do this here today. Don't want to make anyone feel uncomfortable, but I want to offer the opportunity, if you'd like to be anointed with oil and be prayed for, I want to pray for you. I want to pray for healing. If you need healing, I want to pray for provision. If you need provision, amen. I believe the same God that is able to touch Brother Cecil and help him in his condition is the same God that can help you and help anyone that you want to pray for. Amen. So as they sing it again, if you'd like to be prayed for, just come up here. Thank you, sister. We're going to pray in Jesus' name.
We sing to the God who saves. We sing to the God who always makes a way. He hung up on that cross and he rose up from that grave. My God, still rose. We sing to the God who always makes a way.
Take a moment to praise Him. Thank Him for what He's done. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. I want us to leave this place with this understanding. Amen. Our God can do anything. And our faith is in Him. And when we don't understand everything about what's going on around us, just know this, He's not confused. And He's not surprised at the world condition. He's not surprised at where we're at right now. And so when we just put our faith in Him, it's described like this in the scripture. He says, cast your cares on Him, for He cares for you. He takes your heaviness and He makes it lighter. Right. And so don't be afraid to do that. Amen. You say, well, I did that last week. I prayed that same prayer last week. That doesn't confuse God. Right. Keep praying it. Keep believing. Keep trusting in Him. Amen. Well, I'm excited to be able to say Happy Easter to you from LifePoint. Thank you. LifePoint, let's give all of our guests a great big hand. God bless you all. Thank you so much. Love you. Just thrilled that you're here. If you would fill out a guest card for us from your family at least, we're going to do a drawing from some of those here down by the where the egg hunt's going on. So everybody's going to go out there.